Hey everyone, so today I'm going to discuss with you a very simple and nice application of differential equations. So the topic of today's talk is murdered professor. So before going towards the crime scene, let me tell you that this talk is open to general audience. Even if you don't have the basic knowledge of differential equations, it's okay, you will be able to understand the talk. Needless to say, there will be some mathematical content, but I won't go into deep. Trust me, I will just state them and we will see what is the scenario. Okay, so let's go towards the crime scene. So suppose you come to my office with some doubts on Monday, just before 10 a.m. and what you found? I'm dead, I'm lying on the floor. So what you will do? Obviously you will be scared. So what will you do? You immediately called up the police, and police, thank God, they will come on time and they will start taking up measurements. And among them, here are the few measurements which they will also take. So like, they will take my body temperature at 10 a.m. Suppose it's a 30 degrees Celsius. They will take my body temperature at 11 a.m. Say it is 28 degrees Celsius. And the room temperature, suppose AC is on and it's at 24 degrees Celsius. So these are the following data which is available. And police is doing their investigation. While investigating, they feel like, oh, you might be a suspect in this crime scene. And you came to know about that, oh shit, police know that I may be a suspect in this, so I should have an alibi, right? Otherwise, they will put me behind the bars. So what you will do now? That's the question. So before to do something, you should know when the professor died, right? If you know when the professor is died, you can just see at what, at that time, where you were there. Okay, so the first thing you should know is when was the professor died. So to answer that question, you will use differential equations. So if you have seen this subject before or you have seen this talk, now you will know how to find out when the professor died. So here, what is the Newton law of cooling says? It says that if capital T is the temperature of a body, the rate at which the temperature of the body changes is proportional to the difference between the temperature T and the ambient temperature or the surrounding temperature. The surrounding temperature, I will represent it by T suffix A. So what I have is, mathematically, if I write dt by small dt is equal to k times t minus t suffix a, where k is what? It is called as a proportionality constant. So this is nothing but the Newton's law of cooling. Okay, now once we have a differential equation, our main thing is to solve that differential equation. Now there are various methods available to solve differential equation. One of the very basic method is variable separable method. So well, those who are from mathematical background, I will suggest them to get, so you can see my cursor, you can try to find this general solution. Okay, so make sure you do this. If you, those are not from the background, they still want to do, they can see my lecture on variable separable. I will post the link in the description. And those who do not want to do any calculation, they can trust me. And this is the general solution, that T is nothing but T suffix A plus C into e raised to kt. Such kind of models are called as exponential models. Why? Because if you see that E, exponential is coming into the picture. So Newton's law of cooling gives us the exponential model. Okay, now what is T suffix A? I know it is nothing but the room temperature, and the room temperature was 24 degrees Celsius. So I put the value of T of A as 24 degree. Now what are the unknown constants? If you see over here, the unknown constants are K and C. So my job is to find what is K and what is C. Now I will use the remaining two data which police took. So at 10 a.m. they took the temperature of my body, which was 30 degrees Celsius. So if I represent T equal to 0 as 10 a.m. So when my T is 0, my temperature is 30 degree. So if I do that, T of 0 equal to 30, if I put T equal to 0, small t, what I get? I get the value of C. Again, as I said, if you are from mathematical background, I will suggest you to please do this calculation. And if you do not want to do, you can trust me, the calculations are correct. So this is one thing. So using the temperature of my body at 10 a.m. I could find the value of C. Now taking the temperature at 11 a.m. I will find the value of K. Now T equal to 0 corresponded to 10 a.m. So T equal to 1 will correspond to 11 a.m. So when I replace small t by 1, what is my capital T, which is nothing but the temperature of the body? Temperature is 28 degrees. So if I put the value and if I do the calculation, value of K is coming out to be minus 0.4055. And this is what, if you see the cursor over here, this is the solution of the differential equation using the given initial conditions. So this is what the solution is. Okay, so now I have my mathematical model, I have a solution. Now, what is my aim? I want to know when my professor died. Okay, so what we know is the temperature of the body is how much? 37 degrees Celsius. So if I replace my capital T by 37 degrees Celsius in this last equation, if you see over here, if I replace my capital T by 37 degree and doing the calculation, I can find my small t. And if I do the calculation, it is coming out to be approximately 2 hours. It's coming out to be minus 2. So since t equal to 0 corresponded to 10 a.m., so t equal to minus 2 will correspond to 8 a.m. So thanks to Newton's law of cooling, you could calculate that the professor died at around 8 a.m. Okay, so you have enough information now. So now what you want to do? What is your job now? Your job is you should convince police that at 8 a.m. you were not in the college. Or you should get an alibi who can say, okay, this person was with me at around 8 a.m. Or you should show them some CCTV footage or something, so that it will convince police that at 8 a.m. you were not in the college. You were either in your hostel or at the house or on the way. So that how you can get an alibi and you may get free from the police, or your name can be get rid of the suspect list. So that's how Newton's law of cooling may help you to get an alibi. So this is a very simple and nice application of differential equations. So I hope you liked my talk. If yes, do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Next week I will come up with some more videos. Thank you.